sounds of The Big Game by the IBN Orchestra. And when you hear that playing, you know that it is time for the big game, in this case, the finals.
Truly, the finals.
Indeed. As we are live on the DGL Twitch channel to bring you the Legends Hockey League finals, games 3 and 4. As Boston's set to take on Edmonton very soon. And what a season it has been, this season 10 of LHL, and has to come to a close at some point, and this week would appear to be the point that it is going to end. As with all good things. But it's ending on a high note, as this is a pretty good series already. As it is tied 1-1, we come into the middle of this. We are bringing you games 3 and 4. The 5th and 6th and 7th games, whichever are necessary, will be played on Thursday night. But in the meantime, this is going to be quite a game, as these two teams have took different routes to be here, but they have arrived at the end, and only one can prevail to be the LHL champion for season 10. I'm Winners with the One. I'm here with Aila, and we are here to bring you all the action as the teams are getting in and getting set up to play. We'll see who they put out for their starting five, as each team has some great players to choose from. And this should be a lot of fun. Glad you could join us. And now the tension mounts. This is like picks and bans in a MOBA, I suppose, where we decide who is going to play. And they may indeed take up all 4 minutes remaining of the warm-up time to do so, as both teams getting here right on the dot at 7:30 Eastern. You have to admire the punctuality of this league. But Edmonton has got their starting five set at, well, four. That's one left. Okay. Maybe not. No? No? Okay. Oh, they're switching colors. Okay. So just for those of you keeping track at home, Edmonton will be in red, at least for this game. And they are starting Dildozer, Trev Crow, Fat Squirrel, Crab in a Tree, and Big V. Fat Squirrel with a great season in goal. They will be expecting big things from him tonight against a Boston team that is known for scoring goals and lots of them. For Boston in blue, they've got P.K. Pacheng out there in the net for them. No slouch himself in the net. And Kapanen, BGP, wait, bring that back. I was looking at that. That always happens. Deloriax and Dalphan, two of the linchpins of the scoring attack for Boston. They'll be expecting big production from them in front of the net. And the opening draw is done, and we are underway. The LHL Finals, games 3 and 4. This series is tied at 1. And a loose puck is flying around the boards. I think it got all four corners. The words of the great E40 are sharp on all four corners. There you go. We got E-Feezy reference early on, and some action early on, as the puck's just going to go back and forth here. Things take a while to settle down. Both teams getting their rhythm together. Shot on is going to sail over the net, and now a quick pass out. You'll see a lot of this from Boston. You'll see them come out to the line and throw that two-line pass across. And it's like a fastball pitcher in baseball. You know, it's, I'm throwing this at you at 100 miles an hour. You know it, I know it. You either hit it or you don't. And that's kind of the way Boston plays. You know what they're going to do. You know how their plays are set up. Either stop them or you don't. So it's the irresistible force versus the immovable object. And it should prove to be very interesting. Chance in front there. And just off the stick, this one will carry back through. And now Edmonton with a chance in front and sent away. Nice one knocked down there, and Big V is going to gather this back up for Edmonton at center ice. Sent back in, and again some interplay in the middle of the rink. As this one travels back, Big V will take the puck again. A high bouncer behind the net. Edmonton will again take control. Long pass dumped in. Will be Kapanen on the touch for Boston. Stolen chance in front and cleared away. As swarming in front of the net. Boston, we talked about their offense, but you can't get this far in the playoffs without some defense as well. They've had to come up big a couple of times. Long shot scores! Deloriex! Dalphin will get the assist. That was just a rifle shot from Dial. Just finds that corner. What a play.
Absolutely love it.
But now in the other direction, let's see if Edmonton can launch a counterattack here. Cross the line, dumped in. And Boston again regains possession. Down to about a minute and a half in the first period, which has passed by very quickly. Just one goal so far. We expect these games to be fairly close. Now, Boston was pretty dominant as far as the regular season goes. They were at the top of the division pretty much all season long. But last week, they were forced to a Game 7, an overtime Game 7 at that, to fight their way into this finals. So they are no strangers to adversity. And Edmonton making their way past Toronto to get here on the other side of the bracket. And they've got some great players. You look down the list of these names, and it's like, oh, some good names, good players for both teams. But it all comes down to this. Chance in front, fed in. And just off the mark slightly, 18 seconds now. This one is going to be switched up to center ice. Now crabbing a tree. He's got a chance. And what a save! As P.K. Pachin gets one. And that is going to do it for the first period. And goaltending as it's important in the game of hockey, no matter what kind of hockey you're talking about. In this case, we're talking about Hockey Question Mark, which is a free-to-play game and is made by Cryptic Seed. You can get it at hockeyquestionmark.com. And, oh, he's getting it off the draw here with a shot and score! Top shelf! Where Mama keeps the cookies, that's Dillinzer, not Dildozer. There may be a difference. I'm sure there is. But by any name, that is a solid scoring effort. But now on the other side, Fat Squirrel. The record-setting season. Making himself known in the postseason with a Very nice save. So we are tied at one here in the second period. Already seeing glimmers of greatness from both these teams. Edmonton in the red jerseys, Boston in the blue. And the red jerseys have got control of the puck here. So they wait, hold up in the neutral zone. But this one, the pocket is picked. Dalfan launching from distance, and that will end up right next to the water bottle on top of the net as it bounces over. So they will reset it here. BGP will go ahead and dump it in. They're looking for something off the deflection. They're not able to get it. So the long pass the other way. And a chance in front. Shot, score. Crabbing a tree. My goodness.
I am almost speechless.
Almost, Aila. Almost. As fairly tough angle there. A crab in a tree. A proven goal scorer, proving it again here in the finals. So Edmonton with the lead. And they are set to strike again. As here is Crab, who will look for Dillon in front. But this is going to go in the other direction. Oh, a nice pass past everybody. Thal's going to wave at this. Makes its way back up to the point, where it is then cleared away. DK Paching now, quick pass out to Dalfan. You'll see he directs a lot of the offense from right around the blue line and center ice area. Is very good at finding these guys in traffic. So, yeah, you're going to see a lot of that from Boston. And sometimes he'll just throw it in himself like that from downtown. Dalfan ties it up. BGP will get the assist on this one. And we are again deadlocked at 2-2. We're about halfway through regulation time, and Edmonton with the centering pass, and this one blocked and across the crease. Close to danger. And will they be able to hold it here? They do. Gonna send it back in front, and sticks tied up. No clear path to the net. Just go ahead and throw one in slow. PK Paching. Not screened on that one. Fairly easy save for somebody at the PK Paching level of goaltending. But now, oh, the long pass knocked out of the air with the high stick. This kind of game, hockey question mark, does not have a lot of the penalties that you would see in other games. No high sticking. And no offsides and no icing either. So, pretty free-flowing style. Seeing that on display with two of the best teams here. Because it is the finals. Dalfan again, over to the left face-off circle. They'll have to try to chase this one down. Heads back out to the point. Now cleared by Edmonton. And no pressure on Boston. They got time to play this out. Well, Crab in a tree coming in with some pressure. And BG will get past him and go ahead and throw one in, Fat Squirrel. Up to the task. And we're seeing this. It's going back and forth very quickly. Sometimes they're just skipping the neutral zone entirely. Just go for the quick outs. And here's one. Oh, rejected with authority by Fat Squirrel right before time expires on the second period. So we'll go to the third, all tied up at two. You're seeing a very good game here tonight. Two games on the lineup. And hello to the legendary Trev. He's in the chat. And to the millions of people watching around the world, the spectacle of esports. And the double millions that will be watching this later on YouTube. We appreciate your support very much. And so, as we have often said, that the third period is itself quite often the most important period of a hockey game. And I think that that will prove to be the case in this game, barring any extra time that may have to be played, which is a distinct possibility. As these teams match up very well against each other. Now it will be Edmonton. Grabbing a tree. This one picked off. But momentum will carry it back the other way. So it will be a battle in the corner. BG going to win the puck. Get it up to Kapanen. Dial. And close, but not quite where he wanted to make contact with the puck. So Edmonton will dump this back. Here comes Boston. And again, they will quickly play it into the Edmonton zone. And Edmonton will use the other side of the rink to open things up. Crabbing a tree, just kind of lurking around in front, and he finds Dellinger in the middle, and that is a playoff goal right there. And it gives them the lead, 3-2 now, and Fat Squirrel having to make a stop right off the faceoff. And this one bouncing in front, oh, and a little bit of help there to keep that one out of the net. Could have been a deadly goal. And a little battle behind the net. Edmonton will prevail. Back out to center ice. Pass blocked. Race to get to this one. And they will follow it into the corner. And again, Boston will try to look into the front of the net. Edmonton, well aware of that, will take it away from him. So now here is Dalfan. The long pass. Oh! And a couple of the Boston players ready to receive that. So ready that they collide into one another as regulation time ticks down. They've got a minute and a half to try to at least tie this thing up to keep this game three going. And certainly they have done it before. We've seen some very dramatic last minute heroics already from this Boston team in the past. And looking for another one here. This shot will go over the net. And Edmonton just content to send this back over to PK Pacheng and take time off the clock. I'll send it back to Fat Squirrel. We're now under a minute. Game three, Edmonton looking to take a 2-1 lead in the series if they can hold on here. And they are on the offensive attack again, at least for a moment. Boston will get this back, 36 seconds. Feeling some pressure. Dylan grabbing a tree, both down there. Big V on the steal, throws it back in, 27 seconds. PK getting it out as quick as he can, and that's going to take it to the other side of the rink. And this is a good chance for Boston. This is where they need to be. 15 seconds, sent in front. Lots of sticks flying. 10 seconds, cleared out. That is going to do it, most likely. Well, I count them out too quickly. Yeah, okay, now I can say, yeah, that'll do it. For the game three, the GGs come out, and that was indeed a good game. And Edmonton, it's a battle of attrition, really, in that first game of the night. They will take a 2-1 lead against a Boston team that is still very much the odds-on favorites, I think, to take it all this season. So as they say, it's anybody's game. And that's part of the fun of LHL. And it has been an interesting season, this season 10. And yeah, we'll be wrapping it up this week. The rest of it, we won't decide a champion tonight, no matter who wins this game four. The games 5, 6, and 7, as scheduled, permits or is needed, are going to be on Thursday, which you can catch on the HQM network on Twitch TV. Shout out to them and Nova Star and all the guys that do casting over there. Caught some of the games last Thursday. They do a great job. And also shout out to LegendsHockeyLeague.com. That's a very comprehensive website for this league. And they've done an excellent job on that. And that's got links to all the streams. So it makes it easier to find these things. It looks like Boston will be putting Sully in the net. They're going with the Dallas Stars goalie rotation thing, I guess, like they're doing in the NHL. Sully definitely a solid goaltender in his own right, and he's, if this first game was any indication, he's going to have his hands full as Edmonton. I don't know if they had quite as many shots on goal as Boston, but they really took advantage of their opportunities, finished them off. And so, we proceed to our second and final game of the evening. Final game of the season here on the Digital Gaming League. I want to thank the guys at DGL for another great season of LHL hockey. Plan to do it again next season. Sure, why not? Always good times. But thanks to Link and everybody over at DGL. Definitely give them a follow. And off the face off and off the inside of the net and out. No goal for Boston. They get a chance early. Very early. The opening face off. Yeah, this is a team that can turn things around at any time, so it's just a matter of execution. And but Edmonton doing pretty well at being disruptive and just kind of breaking their flow of their style a little bit. But oh, a sneaky one there, as crabbing a tree, hammering one off the back of the boards. Dillons are, well, shoot and score to make it 1-0, and Edmonton takes the lead. Wow.
Certainly a stunner, isn't it?
Yeah. I don't know. You just never know. Regular season performance, as we have seen in LHL, is not always indicative of what might happen in the playoffs. And we're seeing it here. But, again, it's too early to make too many assumptions, but Edmonton is in good position here, and a shot By Big V will go just wide. So Kapanen. Oh, that one took a tough bounce to the middle. Was almost finished off for a second Edmonton goal. So yes, they are looking pretty good here. And this one almost forced through by Boston. But they will have to go back and gather this from behind the net. BG will lead the way. Now over to Kapanen and Dial. And Dial, of course, a prolific goal scorer. Prolific and terrific. They'll be looking for him. And a big save there. As up the stick and over that squirrel. He will go ahead and just scoot this away from the net. So Boston will take this to the boards. And so will Edmonton, all the way back to the opposite end. Dalfan now. And he threads the needle there with a nice pass. Stolen. Big V. Chance. Shot coming in. That's going to go wide. And Boston attempting a clear. And now just a hammer job from Kapanen. Will dislodge the puck. And Boston is on the move again. Sent in front. Oh, and Kapanen's going to get one off the tip. And that was started by Dial, just feeding one in front. And sometimes it's never a bad thing to try. Good things tend to happen, especially in a playoff situation. So now, with under a minute left in the first, oh, grabbing a tree. Man, I was just about to say that this game was tied, but grabbing a tree. Big V on the assist. Under a minute left of the first period, it is 2-1. Edmonton. How about that?
For sure.
Oh, and Dillinger! The centering pass, grabbing a tree. Two goals, two assists, 3-1. Is your score as the first period starts to draw to a close. This Edmonton team, my oh my, they are for real. But Boston, they will gun this in a couple of times before it is cleared back out to center ice. 10 seconds, maybe time for something else here. As again, just good man-to-man defense there. Keeping him from finding someone to pass that to. So we'll go to the second period. 2-goal lead for Edmonton. So where do you go from here if you're one of these teams? Strategy?
Perhaps a measure of unpredictability is called for here.
Well, I wasn't going to say that, but, yeah. Yeah, because like we said, by now, you kind of know how they're going to play this out. So, I mean, we saw it. Washington, in the series they had with Boston, they kind of had their number on a lot of this stuff. And they forced them to 7 games, very nearly won. So, yeah, we know that these are some of the most skilled players in all of hockey? here on this Boston team. But yeah, they may have to switch up the style a little bit, perhaps. I mean, that's when they found their most success in the playoffs, it has seemed. When Dial just gets out there and goes for crazy stuff. It may be time for some Dial right about now. And the centering pass will go just off the blade. So, yeah, things like that have kind of snake-bitten them a little bit, too. And some of it just kind of those weird bounces beyond their control throughout the playoffs. Just hitting the post. And just an inch here, an inch there. But you cannot count this team out. But Edmonton just handling them well so far through game three, which they won. And this is game four. We are midway through the second period. Oh! And just wide on that one. He had a good look at the net. And now this one coming across. Just brought up a little short. Yeah, things like that. Sometimes you eat the bar, and sometimes the bar eats you. But, as we say, plenty of time left on the clock. Plenty of hockey left to play here. Plenty of chances for both these teams to shine. We are at the two-minute mark, almost, of the second period. And here is a good chance, and blocked. He's going to get a chance for his own rebound. Spins, fires, and he stays with him. And a very nice defense from this Edmonton team. Trying to get a little offense in front. But it will be Boston on the quick counterattack. Seeing pressure, we'll switch this up. Kapanen now stolen, though. They will get it back at the center line, and now cleared away for BG to begin play once again. As Edmonton trying to go up 3-1 here in the finals. Shot coming in off the post, rebound, dangerous, cleared away. And now the quick pass out to Kapanen. He'll get a chance at this. That is blocked. And a second chance will also find its way to somebody's stick and far from the net. BG firing one in. It will go wide. From the other side, Dalfan takes a look. Now a shot from Dial. Now Dalfan. Now in front. Now traveling through. It will be Dial getting it back. 19 seconds. He may be looking to the front here again for the center pass. Again, Edmonton. They're all back there. And they are keeping a close watch on the Boston goal scorers. And stifling their attempts to try to even things up here. As we go to the third period, it is 3-1 Edmonton. Are they going to shock the world? It's LHL, it's hockey question mark. Anything can happen. We've learned to accept that and live with it. You know, that's part of the fun. It's esports, man. Real esports shit right here. As this third period is probably the most important period of hockey so far this season for this Boston team. The shot! Oh! Yeah, that's the kind of stuff they're going to have to do. Just so close, though. And on many nights, we see shots from Dial like that that we marvel at because they go in. How did he do that? But the postseason has had its share of frustration for Boston. Can they overcome it? This is the time to strike. Yeah, they've got 4 minutes here in regulation. In danger of going down to being one game away from elimination. Can they instead make this a 2-2 series? That's a good start there, as that one looked like it picked up a couple of sticks. Oh, and the redirect! It counts. That was off an Edmonton player, but Dial just is catching him out with that one. And so Boston pulling it back to within one goal with 3 minutes left. They'll take them any way they can get them at this point. And really, that's what playoff hockey is all about. Shot save. Bat squirrel. And again, he had a very solid rookie season as a goalie in this league. He's going to, I suspect, have a busy couple of minutes here as time ticks down. And the Boston attack will become a lot more pronounced. One would think, but crabbing a tree. We'll go ahead and fire this back in. Dylan in the corner. BG will gain the puck and gain the line and just send this all the way down. Oh, set up in front. Just, oh man, stuff like that. The deflection, just enough to divert that one into the post instead of between the pipes. Yes. It's like the Blackhawks the other night in the LHL. Sometimes that's the difference between victory and defeat. It's just weird shit like that. Hockey, man. Esports, man. LHL, man. You know. Just hockey things. So, the pace is going to have to pick up here as we near the 1 minute mark. And Edmonton in red, 3-2 lead. Can they hold on? Again, they're just smothering them in their own zone. But that's going to leave somebody open. And that somebody is Kapanen. He will dish this across. Dillinger is going to pick it up, though. And Edmonton will keep possession. And with a chance in front. Trying to play that one off the bounce as momentum carries him past the puck. And so they will try again. Looking for that one-timer. But this puck is going back the other way and is taking an interesting bounce. It's up on top of the net. Will be whacked loose, gathered up, 13 seconds. Boston has to work quickly. 9 seconds, stolen again. Big V taking his time, fires it in. This will go wide, but it will eat up the clock. And Edmonton takes a 3-1 lead in this series over the heavy favorites from Boston. Wow.
Were you expecting anything like this?
Well, not like this. Not like this. Expected this one to go all seven games. And it's not out of the question. It will come down to who plays well on Thursday. Remember that you can catch all that on the HQM network. Nova Star and crew will be on hand to bring you the culmination of this season 10. But you have to give some credit to this Edmonton team. They're playing very well on offense, but they're really playing well on defense, and they're just really not letting Boston move the puck around the way they do. I mean, Boston plays a very finesse-oriented game, and sometimes it's just, it seems like they're on another level, but some physical play from Edmonton. Some good work from Dillinger and crabbing a tree to make goals happen. And they have pushed this Boston team to the brink of elimination. So an interesting turn of events this evening to wind out our coverage of LHL and DGL for Season 10. And again, we want to thank everybody who has been watching. You've seen some cool things happen if you have been watching. And if you haven't, we hope that you will start picking it up, because this is high-level work from all of these teams in the LHL, from top to bottom. It is a great league. And the North American game growing very strong. Now, we will be back on Friday night, Aila and myself, as we are on the IBN channel, IBN 1, as we will be looking at the HQML playoffs, which have been spectacular themselves, as we will see Seuss's Loose take on the Freedom Commies in a best of five to determine who will go on to the finals of HQML. Right now, hockey at the usual bat time on the usual bat channel, the Independent Broadcast Network. But again, as this is wrapping up our coverage of the league for this season, we want to thank everybody at LHL and thank Dial and all the crew and everybody who does stuff behind the scenes to support the community and help things grow. There are a lot of you, and you're doing excellent work, and we appreciate you very much. We will be back also in the off season, of course. Ayla and I, we do DGL for Lovers Only, where we will be back at this same time slot on Tuesday night to bring you weird shit. You will not want to miss it. And so we will probably find some sort of crazy weeb visual novel or something that scares the insurgency kids, because not much does scare them, but that certainly does. So that's always a good time. We hope you will join us for that. And give us a follow on all the usual social media crap. You can see it at the bottom of the screen there. Follow us on Twitter, Winners of the One, IBN Aila, and of course the DGL underscore org, I believe it is. Yes. I should know this stuff by now. We've been doing this for several seasons. But it's always a pleasure, and we can't thank everybody enough. I'm just kind of amazed at what we've seen. This Edmonton team is definitely looking good, and if tonight is any indication, they will be looking to finish this thing off on Thursday and be the champions of Season 10 of LHL. So Boston will have to make a dramatic comeback to push this to seven games, and they've pushed them to seven games before, so we shall see. The world waits with bated breath. And we will see you next time whether it is DGL for Lovers Only, or whether it's more hockey, or whether it's other games that we'll be casting that are coming up very soon. It's always a good time. So from all of us here at the DGL, from the Legends Hockey League, from the Independent Broadcast Network, on behalf of Aila and myself, Winners with One, we thank you, we salute you, we love you. See you next time. Good night.
See ya.